Our next caller claims to be the mother of Elvis's love child, Shirley. You're on the air.
Elvis Jr., or as we call him, Gene, can't get to sleep. He's scared of storms.
Yeah, like I care. What I want to know is, how did you and Elvis meet, and does little Dickens have sideburns?
Wait, I think I know that love child. Go ahead, Shirley. Tell me a little more about Gene's problem.
He could probably get to sleep if you told him a story. Maybe something about a frog.
What a coincidence. I just happen to know a good frog story.
Why do we get all the weirdos here? Now, I'm going to go to our next call.
No, we won't. I'm taking this call.
Hey, whose show is this?
Another word, and you'll be hosting It Hurts When I Talk.
Thank you, Mr. Harper. And I'm speaking for little Elvite everywhere. Turn on the radio. Your dad wants to talk to you.
He's on the phone?
Better yet.
But I'll try to remember it the best I can. Once there was a little frog who said to his father, "I am leaving home." Well, then said his father, "I will become the road and travel with you."
"Then I will become a balloon and float up into the sky."
Well, then said the father frog, "I will become a bird and soar after you and catch your string with my beak."
Well, then said the little frog,
"I will become a stone and fall through a chimney and hide in the house." Well, then said the father, "I will become a key to open the door and find you."
"Then we'll be together again, where I can hold you tight and keep you safe. Good night, Gene."
"Good night, Dad. Good night, Winnie. Thanks."
Stay tuned. The magic continues.
So you didn't have any dreams at all?
Well, one. But I can't tell you about it till I'm older.
Rob, did you finish your paper?
No, Dad, but this time I have a really good excuse.
Rob, give me a break. I am so tired of your excuses. Do you know, for once, I would like the truth? The whole truth. And nothing but the truth.
Go ahead. Okay. First, a branch crashed through the French doors, and they became a dance hall with honky-tonk music and beautiful babes, 10 cents a dance, but Winnie and Jesse wouldn't let me in. Then, Winnie grabbed a couple of fireplace tools, went outside, and took a lightning bolt. Zzz, which, of course, she had to do because the phone was a duck.
Rob, you have outdone yourself. That was the most ridiculous, the most preposterous story I have ever heard in my life.
Oh, I'll get it.
No, the duck's for me.
Are you afraid of blowing your diet this Christmas? Monday on The Home Show, Richard Simmons has ways to survive holiday temptations. Also, you're invited to the old Kentucky home of Phyllis George, Monday at home.
Tuesday, following Who's the Boss, Kevin's Christmas spirit is dull when it is clear that a color TV is beyond the family budget on The Wonder Years. Now stay tuned for Homeroom.